My name is Vito Scaletta. I was born in Sicily in 1925. That little guy's me. I'm standing there with my parents and my sister Francesca in front of our old house. I don't really remember too much about the old country, except that we were pretty hard up. And then one day my father decided it was time to move away. Away from Sicily, across the ocean, to start a new life in America. Seen anything as fantastic as Empire Bay. It was beautiful. On the other hand, I'd never seen anything filthier, more disgusting than our new shithole of an apartment. The American dream. It was more like a nightmare. My father started working at the port for the guy who arranged our immigration. It was backbreaking work, and what little money he made mostly went towards booze. Eventually, my parents sent me to school. I had to learn English. I sure as hell wasn't gonna do that in a neighborhood full of Italians. That's where I met Joe.
Come on, Vito, hurry it up. We ain't got all night.
Over time, Joe and I got to be best friends. And since we were both poor and there wasn't much work around, we started a little business of our own.
Freeze! Police! Stop!
Vito, this way! Throw me to bed!
Stop! I'll shoot!
Shit.
Okay, you bastard. Spread your legs.
Fuck.
And put your hands on the fence.
I'm sorry, Vito.
Well, that one time it didn't work out so good. The year was 1943. America was at war, and the army was looking for guys who spoke the language to help with the invasion of Sicily. I was 18, and anything seemed better than jail. Who says you can't go home again?
Operation Husky. I was assigned to the 504th Parachute Infantry. On the 11th of July, we were supposed to be dropped over the southern coast of Sicily, but we got hit by flak and had to bail out, way behind enemy lines. Only three of us made it. If it wasn't for the local resistance, we wouldn't have had a chance. So when Mussolini soldiers came into the town and started rounding everybody up, we decided to return the favor.
Se nessuno parla, quest'uomo morirà.
No.
Ammazzare tutti che dica giù.
Cosa state parlando?
Dicevo al mio amico di stare attento.
Fregatene di fare attenzione, fai ciò che ti è stato detto!
Davvero Don Calò?
Cacetto, un congetto quando si maretta come cucina.
Ma chi è quello? Lo conoscete?
Lo conoscono tutti. Don Calò è un uomo d'onore.
È uno stupido turco degli americani, non ditemi che gli credete.
No, è davvero Don Calò. Ogni tanto dovresti ascoltare i consigli di noi altri del posto. Ci rendiamo.
Sapete che potete fidarvi di me. Che ne dite,
eh? Don Calò, the head of the Sicilian mob. An entire garrison of troops surrendered that day. Why?
because he told them to. A few years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. Then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
Vito! Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure. Salud.
A salud, chin down. So how come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait. You mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't wanna go back, do you?
Nah, of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here.
Both mother and daughter, working for the Yankee dollar.
Hey, Giuseppe, it's Joe. Remember last week, you know, the guy's name is... Vito Scaletta. Thanks, Giuseppe. All right, I'll see you later. Situation is mighty queer, like the Yankee girl. Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Oh, did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome. Como uno frade, you're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you wanna ride?
No, thanks. I wanna walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
Can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow. Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Vito, my boy. My boy's home. I thought I'd never see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
Sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner. Zuppa di pollo. It's good for you.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah. Sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry. Benedice, Signore, la mangiata, che per tua volontà. Stiamo ricevendo, providene pure un cucino di umano. Per Cristo nostro Signore.
Amen. So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe, you want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly.
No.
Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Pappalardo. He's in the union. You could talk to him. Work hard like you were your papa. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie a Dio.
Ah, fuck this.
Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here.
You're gonna be sorry. The both of you.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
Hey,
this is bad.
We ain't getting out at all. Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. What do we have to stop when we can all have fun?
The fun's over, baby. Later, I say. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. You know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you could stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the $20 the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go. Hey, Giuseppe, I brought
Hello,
you a
Joe.
New customer.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
retired,
Bay.
Please. How are you? The papers for you?
Yeah, they are. You got them finished already?
It was a pain in the ass, but sure, they're done.
Well, thanks. This really gonna work?
Nobody from the army will bother you again, trust me.
You see? What'd I tell you? Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
Hey, look who's here.
Hey, Mikey boy, what's going on? Shit, Mike, you could wash your fucking hands once in a while. Now I need a fucking bath.
Hey, I've been working. Working people occasionally get dirty, you know? Besides, I just wiped them off.
With what? The same fucking rag you used to clean the toilet, you filthy fuck?
Put a lid on it. What are you, from the health department, or you want to do some business?
Business, of course. This here's my friend Vito. Vito, this is Mike Bruschi. But don't shake his hand. I ain't got that much soap at home.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
Me and Vito go way back. He just come back from overseas and he needs some cash. So I figure he can help with your, supply problem. I can vouch for him.
Uh-huh. Okay. Joe told you about our side business, right?
Yeah.
I only want regular cars, nothing fancy. You get a cut of every car. I take as many as I can handle. And don't bring no cops around, okay? They follow you here. I don't know your ass from Jesus. You get me?
Got it.
God damn it, Mike! You put your grubby mitts on my fucking coat. I paid a fortune for this thing.
All right, calm down or I'll stick them up your ass, you sissy.
You know, dry cleaning costs
Jesus
these days
Christ.
Plenty. And who knows if they can even get this filth
you
out.
You shut up. Vito, listen to me. I need a Walter coupe today. I got a few people looking for parts, but I can't find a car.
Because you don't know where to look. Every time I drive down Hunters, I see one parked by a bar there. I think the place is called the Lone Star.
Isn't that a Moulinyan neighborhood? I'll stick out like a sore thumb.
All right, look, I'll give you $350 for it. It's worth the risk, right?
400.
All right, deal.
Vito, come on, let's go. Andiamo. Meantime, I'll be sending you the cleaning bill for my coat.
Yeah, I'll change my address, you rat prick.
Okay, listen up. This is your maiden voyage, so to speak. So try not to fuck it up, man. Here, Vito, take this, just in case.
Hey, nice. Hey, Mike, you mind if I test this thing out here?
Sure. Knock yourself out. Here you go. Aim for that old wreck over there.
It's that cream-colored baby over there. Be careful. Do it quick and get the fuck out of there. Break a window if you have to and go. I'll wait for you back at Mike's.
What if I run into problems?
Then you deal with them. Look, consider this a test. If you fail, I hear they're hiring down at the factory.
Right, just asking.
Good luck, pal. I see you back at Mike's.
Hey! Hey, what you doing, motherfucker?
Hey, mission accomplished. How'd it go?
Yeah, piece of cake. Except for the fact that the car belonged to a bunch of moolies who immediately tried to kill me right after you left.
Probably the bombers. Hunt is their neighborhood. Guys like that, you don't have to worry about them. They just hang out on the street, talk shit, steal shit, and smoke dope. Let's see what we got here.
Nice. No stains. Clean.
The lowlife get the money for this. Probably stole it himself. It's nice, though. How much did I say I'd give you for it again?
600.
Oh, I like your buddy, Joe. Here's your 400 bucks. Stop by again, okay? We can do some more business.
Yeah, you bet, Mike.
I see you, Mike. I'll stop by again real soon.
All right, boys. I'll see you later.
Here's your 300 bananas. I'm taking my cut as the middleman. Next time, you're on your own.
All right. Thanks, Joe.
Close the door. It's windy. What do you want?
Yeah, I'm looking for a Mr. Pappalardo.
Oh, yeah? Why?
My name's Vito Scaletta. My old man used to work for him, and I'm looking for a job, so I came here.
Well, you're in the right spot, sonny boy. Federico Pappalardo at your service. You can call me Derek. I think I remember your dad. Good guy, but drank like a fish. What's he up to these days?
He's dead.
Oh, well, y'all gotta go sometime. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
So you need a job, huh? Well, you're in luck. We just got a new shipment to unload. Steve will show you around. Now scram, my steak's getting cold.
Follow me. Load this pile of crates onto that truck. When you're done, you get 10 bucks. If something gets lost or broken, you get nothing. Start now and don't take all day.
Yeah, I'm done. And you can keep the 10 bucks. When I said I needed a job, I didn't mean slave labor.
Whatever. Get the fuck out of here, then. Don't show your face around here again.
Yeah, don't worry. I can make 100 times more working for Barbaro Incorporated.
Wait, you said Barbaro? Joe Barbaro?
Yeah, so what?
Shit. Nobody who works with Joe would carry crates for 10 bucks. What the hell are you doing? Come with me.
What now?
Well, this one don't like manual labor.
What the fuck?
Said he works with Joe Barbaro.
Bullshit. Who wanna load crates if he works with Joe? You'll have to explain this one to me, sonny boy. What's your story?
Well, my mother wanted me to come talk to you about an honest job, but I need some real money, so this ain't gonna cut it.
Them women, they're all the same. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
She doesn't want you hanging around with Joe, right? My mother was the same way. Look what become of me. Union boss. I got the whole fucking waterfront under my thumb. So how's Joe?
Pretty good, I guess.
How'd you meet up with him?
Oh, we go way back to the old neighborhood. I just come back from overseas and he's putting me up until I can get back on my feet.
Listen, you gotta understand, a person in my position has gotta be careful.
Certainly.
So you won't mind if I give Joe a call, right?
Nah, go ahead.
Now, where'd I put his number? Hey, here it is. He might not be home. That wouldn't be good. Hi, Joe. Hey, this is Derek. Listen, I got this guy here. What'd you say your name was?
Vito.
Vito. He's looking for a job. He says he's a friend of yours. A good friend. I just wanted to check with you first. Uh-huh. Sure, war hero and all that shit. All right. Thanks, then. I'll talk to you later. Sorry, pal, I had to check you out. Joe says you just come back from Italy. You must be able to handle yourself. You want to make a little more money? I got just the thing. The guys here at the port are supposed to pay a monthly fee to the barber, but half of them never cough it up. I need someone to give them a little nudge. $10 a man.
What if they don't need a haircut?
Well, then you'll have to convince them otherwise.
I see. What if somebody makes a fuss?
Then you kick the shit out of them.
Well, let's say you teach them a lesson that doesn't require that they miss work. You got it? Which is why Steve ain't doing the job. Right, Steve?
Right, boss.
Collect at least $150, I give you 50. Just for walking around, taking in the sea air and meeting new people. Easy fucking money, eh? What do you say?
Here's the money, boss man.
Good job. Here's your share. I watched you take care of Bill. You were good. Steve damn near got his ass kicked when he tried that. Right, Steve?
Yeah, right, Derek.
Here's a bonus for sorting him out.
Thanks.
The guy's been a real fucking pain. Now get out of here, kid. I gotta be getting back to business. Say hello to your mother for me. Tell her you got yourself a job as my new assistant.
Yeah, will do. I'll see you later.
Hey, where the hell you been?
I came right over as soon as you called. What's going on?
You remember the wise guys we used to see when we was kids?
Yeah, why?
The guy we're meeting here is one of them. His name's Henry Tomasino. I think he's got something big for us.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah. We're done with the small-time jobs. It's time to make some real shkatol. Here, he's coming. Don't say nothing stupid.
Hey, Henry, how are you?
Hi, Joe. This the guy?
Yeah, this is Vito, an old friend of mine.
Good to meet you, Henry.
You vouch for him?
Absolutely, Henry. Trust him with my life.
Okay, listen. I got a job for you. The money's good. I need gas stamps. They're worth a fortune now because of the gas shortage.
Where can we get them?
In the Office of Price Administration.
That's a federal government agency. Isn't that a little risky?
What? Too much for you?
No. Just trying to think of how we can pull it off.
It can't be that hard. The stamps are kept in the safe at night, but the keys are probably around here somewhere.
You got somebody inside?
Yeah, one of our guys. His sister works there.
Can she help us out?
Ask her yourself. Her name's Maria Agnello. Here's the address. Tell her I sent you.
All right, what about the safe? What if the keys aren't there?
That's your problem.
But what's the job pay?
I'll give you $600 for 10,000 gallons worth of stamps.
Okay, we're in.
No, I need Vito to do this alone. I got another job for you, Joe.
So? What do you say, Vito?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, and don't forget to take a piece with you. You never know what's gonna happen. Better to be safe than sorry. I got beef.
Wait. This isn't some liquor store stick-up. I want this to be a clean job. If you kill anybody, your cut drops to a third. Gabish?
Yeah, I got it. No problem.
Okay, when you're done, you come back in, we'll settle up.
All right, I'll see
you. Good luck, Vito.
Yeah, can I help you?
Yeah, hello, ma'am. Henry Tomasino sent me. He said you might be able to help me with a little problem down at the Office of Price Administration.
Yeah, I heard about that. What do you need from me?
I need to get in there tonight.
All right, tell you what. My sister's in the hospital right now. If you give me a lift over there, I'll tell you everything you need to know. It's right across the street from the OPA, so it ain't like you're gonna be going out of your way.
Sure, no problem.
Mom, how'd you make out?
Piece of cake. They're in for a shock in the morning.
That's good. I see Joe knows how to pick his friends. Let's see what we got here. Ah, shit.
Something wrong?
You bet your ass there's something wrong. These stamps you took have an expiration date, and that date is tomorrow.
So, what exactly does that mean?
It means they're gonna be fucking worthless. But wait, if you can get them to the gas station attendants by midnight, they'll be able to stamp them and redeem them. You better bring them to every gas station in town. They gotta get there by midnight or we're screwed. If you don't sell them in time, you get nothing.
Wait a minute, that wasn't our deal. You didn't say anything about any expiration dates.
Well, shit happens, doesn't it? Look, you pull this off, I won't forget it, trust me. Now get going. The faster you unload them, the more money you get.
Jeez. Look at this. Didn't know Joe could even write.
We got another job. Something really big. Stop by Freddy's tonight. Bring a piece and some lockpicks.
Hey,
look who's here. Where the hell you been? Laying around in bed all day?
Hey, I'm entitled to a little rest after that last job, don't you think? What can I get you, sir? Coffee.
Check what he owes for now. Just for now. And when Alberto hears about this, the shit is gonna hit the fan. Believe you me.
So, I heard you didn't score too big last night.
Well, it wasn't exactly my fault. Shit happens.
All right, come on, relax, fellas. It's a high-risk business. If you don't like it, you can always go break your back working for peanuts down at the docks.
Sorry, Henry, I was just breaking balls, you know. So how about tonight? We still on for what we talked about yesterday?
We'll see in a minute.
That is 2 fucking months, 2 fucking many. I want my money!
What? You think I'm running some kind of fucking charity here? Do it. Now!
Who was that?
Somebody you don't need to know right now. All right, listen up. There's a guy who owes the boss some money. He borrowed it to open some big jewelry store. He's not paying it back fast enough. We're gonna collect his payment tonight. In jewels. Plus, a little extra for our trouble. Joe, fill him in.
The jewelry store's in the shopping mall in the middle of town. There's no guards at night. So all we gotta do is pick the lock and waltz right in.
Sounds a little too simple.
Because it is simple. Why's everything gotta be so fucking complicated with you?
Says the guy who can barely change a light
bulb. Look, don't worry. I thought of everything. I got these phone company uniforms so we can pretend to be fixers. So.
Fair enough. Let's go.
All right. We're gonna rob this fuck blind. All we gotta do is wait until dark. What the hell is this?
Come on, boys. The cops will be here any minute. Move it!
Ryan fucking O'Neill?
What the fuck is this?
You crazy bastard, what the fuck are you doing?
Barbaro, what the hell are you doing here, you fuck?
You're a little late, Chief. There's nothing left here for you.
Fuck off, Fatso. This is our heist. You want to get out of here in one piece, you'd better hand over everything you've got.
Well, the sign outside didn't say Brian O'Neill's place. If it did, I wouldn't have robbed it. Instead, I would have set it on fire.
1031 reported at the West Side Mall. Repeat, 1031. Burglary in progress.
This is car 54. We're on it.
And I suggest you get lost before the cops show up.
Fuck!
Kiss my ass.
Fuck out of here.
Get your ass over here. You waiting for a formal fucking invitation?
Over there! Shoot!
Shit. Jesus, be careful. Almost lost you there.
Yeah, I think I just shit myself.
Where'd they go?
They must have gone this way, Sarge. Oh, fuck that. I don't get paid enough for this.
Fuck off, copper! I didn't do nothing!
Look at the Irish, my ass.
Who the hell was that?
Brian O'Neill. Crazy Mick bastard. Not too bright. Usually works his hired muscle.
Yeah, I didn't think he was the brains of the operation.
Shit, the cops. Come on, get out of the light. Let's go! Come on, come on, come on!
Don't worry. Give me a bag. I'll go ditch the goods. All right, pal. Meet you back home. Try not to get pinched on the way there.
Hey there, handsome.
Hi there.
Joe ain't here right now. He said for you to meet him for lunch at Freddy's.
I see.
Too bad you were passed out when I came in. We could have partied. Maybe next time, doll. Bye.
Huh. That was something.
You belong.
Hey, fellas.
Hey. Hey, Vito, this is Luca Garino. He'd like to talk to you and Joe. Luca, this is Vito.
Good to meet you, Mr. Garino.
No need to be so formal. Call me Luca. Take a seat, Vito.
What can I get you?
Same thing I'm having. And hurry it up. I heard about you running with the mix. Great fucking story. And I want to congratulate you, too, on a job well done. Salute.
A salute.
You guys did a hell of a job. Not too many guys got the stomach for this line of work. So now, I'm wondering if yous are ready to take the next step.
Yeah, sure. What next step?
I'm talking about taking somebody out. Just because someone points his finger at him and tells you to do it.
I was in the war, Mr. Garino. All I did was kill people I was told to kill. People the president pointed his finger at.
That's good. The president. Yeah, I like that. Yeah. But you're talking about the Krauts, right? You know, the bad guys. That's not what I mean. Understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Good. We need guys like you. Guys who can follow orders without asking questions. You handle this next job like you handled the last one, and there's a good chance you'll be accepted into the family. After you pay the initiation fee, of course.
And how much is that?
$5,000 apiece.
That's a fucking fortune.
Hey, nobody said it was cheap, huh? But trust me, the benefits far outweigh the cost. I'll leave it up to you two to decide. Henry's gonna fill you in on the rest. I'll see his guys later.
There you are.
Hey, your boss.
You take care of that thing we talked about yet?
Yeah, it's all under control.
That's what you said the last time. Don't disappoint me again.
Boss,
Now come with me. We got some other business to discuss.
So, Henry, what kind of job we talking about here?
I gotta take a guy out. It's my contract, but I need some help. That's where you two come in.
Who's the lucky guy?
Some fat fuck from across the river. The guy's been warned, but he thinks he's untouchable.
Huh. And is he?
Well, somebody tried to take him out once before.
And?
Let's just say they slightly underestimated him.
How much is slightly?
Fatally.
That's a fancy way of saying they're dead, right?
Hey, they fucked up. We won't. I rented an apartment across the street from his business. We'll sit there, and we'll wait till that fat fuck shows up, and then boom! We blast his ass.
How are we gonna do that?
With an MG-42.
Where are we getting an MG-42 from?
Harry.
Yeah.
He's a vet, like you. He's got a private little gun shop over in Kingston. You can get your anything from a pea shooter to a bazooka. And you don't need no fucking gun license, neither.
Okay, Joe and me will go to the apartment. You go pick up the machine gun at Harry's shop in Kingston. It's all paid for. Just tell him I sent you. After that, meet us at the apartment. It's in Sand Island. The building across from the distillery. Apartment 233.
Okay, apartment 233. Got it. I'll meet you fellas there in a bit.
All right, see you later.
Good luck, pal.
Hello?
So, you're the guy Henry was telling me about, huh?
Yeah. You got his merchandise.
Yeah, well, here it is. MG-42, made in Germany. Hitler's buzzsaw, we call them. She's a beauty. 25 pounds. 7.92 caliber. 1,200 rounds per minute. Fastest in the world. 250-round belt, 3/4 mile effective range, and extremely reliable. I don't know what the hell you're hunting, but unless it's in a fucking tank, sayonara, baby. Hey, you need me to show you how to use it?
No, thanks. I'm familiar with him. I was in the service, too.
No shit! Wait, you're kidding me. Where were you? What was it, Normandy, huh? No, Africa? All right, let me guess.
Operation Husky.
Yeah? What unit were you in?
504th Parachute.
No shit, you were a paratrooper? That was kind of hairy, I heard.
Yeah, well, it wasn't no picnic, I tell you. I got hit, so they sent me home.
Yeah, any medals?
Yeah, Purple Heart and a DSC.
Whoa, wait, you got a cross? Let me tell you, they don't give those babies out for nothing. I was in Normandy. We hit Utah Beach. Yeah, that wasn't no picnic neither, but... When I was crawling over the fence on the way back, I poked my eye out on a fucking tree branch. Well, hey, it was good enough for a discharge.
Look, guy, I really gotta get going.
All right. Hey, by the way, I'm Harry.
Hey, Vito.
Hey, good to meet you, Vito. Real good. If you ever need some hardware, you know where to find me. Here you go. I hope you drove here. She's a big girl. Good luck.
Hey, thanks. Nice to meet you, Harry. Where are you from, Henry?
Sicily.
What brought you to the States?
Mussolini.
We buy you a ticket.
Don't be a smartass, Joe. My father was a man of honor. Things got pretty bad for us after Mussolini came into power. My old man figured I'd either get drafted or locked up. So he sent me to America and got me a job working for Clemente.
So what happened to your father?
He said he was too old to make the trip. Mussolini had him arrested, and he died in jail. They won't even turn his body over for a proper burial.
That's rough.
So how's your English so good?
They're coming! Those black cars!
Vito, aim for the fat bastard. We gotta nail him before he gets in the building. Get ready.
All right, I'm on.
They got guns.
All right, showtime.
They got guns up there in that window.
Don't kill me. Please, I got a wife.
You should have thought about your wife
I'm
before.
I'm doing what you want. Don't kill me. Oh, for Christ's sake.
Don Clemente sends his regards. Oh, fuck!
Fuck you! What? Sorry, you
fuck.
Henry, you okay? Where'd he hit you?
Of course I'm not fucking okay. He shot me in the fucking leg.
Oh yeah, it's bleeding all
Son
over.
Son of a! Get me to El Greco.
The fucking painter?
No, the fucking doctor, okay, you
take
idiot.
Take it easy. I'm gonna get you there in a minute.
The Greek guy lives up in Highbrook.
All right, let's get you to the car.
Oh, Maradona, you're heavier than you look.
All right. Oh, God.
Ah, fuck. You El Greco, the doctor?
No, I'm the fucking painter.
A friend needs help, or he's gonna bleed to death.
Thanks, Doc.
Good God, Henry.
We owe you one.
Get him inside. Hello, though.
Wait. I got money for you. For the job. Take it.
You know, this could have waited. But thanks.
And hey, thanks for everything.
Hope you'll be okay.
Yeah, me too.
I'll stay here with him. Meet me at my place.
All right.
Vito, hey, how you doing?
Shh, no. I just wanted to give you the money to pay off Papa's debt.
Oh, Vito, that's great. I was gonna try and see if we could pay it back in installments. I got a little money. He wouldn't have hurt us.
Don't be so sure, but it doesn't matter now. Here, take
Where'd you get all this money, Vito? You haven't done nothing you'll be sorry for, have you?
Don't worry. Everything's fine.
Thank you, Vito. Thank you.
No problem. Alright, look, I better be going. I don't want Ma to see me. She'll be asking where I got the money, too.
Don't worry. I'll make something up.
Alright. Give her a big kiss for me,
will.
Okay?
Take care of yourself, Vito.
Vito Scaletta?
Yeah? What's it to you?
You're under arrest for the illegal distribution of federal ration stamps. You're coming with us.
One of the gas station attendants ratted me out. The guy fingered me and they strung our mama into telling them where I was staying. But they had no idea who I was working for and I wasn't about to tell them. Henry was able to get me a lawyer, courtesy of his boss, Clemente. I was up Schitt's Creek, but at least I had a battle. Could have been a hell of a lot worse if the feds knew about any of my other activities.
To be even more serious, considering the fact that you stole national resources at a time when our country needs them the most. An act the gravity of which you, Mr. Scaletta...
The guy was good, but even he couldn't get me out of this one. It was a lost cause from day one. 3 months later, they handed down the verdict.
Vittorio Antonio Scaletta, for your crimes against the people of this city and of this great country, this court hereby sentences you to 10 years in a federal penitentiary.
Murderers, child molesters, they're all here. The worst of the worst.
All right, get in line, gentlemen. Follow me, single file.
and no monkey business, or else. Stop right there. Turn to your right. Your other right.
Listen up, assholes. My name is Captain Terrence Stone, and this is my prison. You're here on the inside because you can't behave like normal human beings on the outside. Make no mistake. Your ass belongs to me now, and you'll do what I say, or you'll be sorry that you didn't. Fuck with me, and I'll fuck with your sorry ass all day long. You were sent here to be rehabilitated, and rehabilitate you, we will.
Okay, you assholes. We're gonna cut you loose just long enough to get yous cleaned up. Now get in line and follow me.
Welcome to the salon, ladies. You're gonna look just fucking beautiful.
Hey, me too? I ain't got nothing on my head to cut.
Shut your face, cue ball.
After three action-packed days of staring at the wall, I got a message from Joe to contact a guy named Leo Galante, who could supposedly help me out in here. This wasn't the kind of place where you could survive on your own.
How much is it in years? Two?
Well, there's 365 days in a year.
Come on, man! Keep it going! Keep it going!
Yes. They set us up? The bomb!
You see me,
you are on the path of destruction.
I know you.
You're that fucking guinea who was with Barbaro in the jewelry store. I'm in this fucking hellhole because of you.
You got locked up because you're a stupid, crazy fuck.
You know, fellas, me ma was right. There is a God! And he sent you here, you guinea bastard, so that I could pay you back!
This looks interesting. Want to make a small bet?
Step back!
Okay,
did you hear me?
Get out of here!
Both of you are going to the hole!
We're gonna give you a little time to think about what you've done. Close it up.
So O'Neill almost took my head off, but I made a stand. Let me tell you something, when you're inside, counts for a lot more than you might think.
How long are you planning on keeping him in here?
Long enough to learn his lesson.
That's gonna have to change. He in any shape to fight?
Should be. Boys didn't knock him around too bad after the brawl in the yard. All right, open it up. Rise and shine, Scaletta. You got yourself a visitor.
My name is Leo Galante. I heard you wanted to speak to me.
Yeah. One of Clemente's guys said I should contact you. Said maybe you could help me out.
Oh, fuck Clemente. I don't provide protection for his guys in here. But I saw how you handled that Mick who's after you, O'Neill. He could prove useful. Come with me, boy. Now listen up, fellas. This is Vito. He's gonna be helping us out. Pepe here's got a big fight coming up. Against O'Neill. He needs a sparring partner. And from what I saw of you out there in the yard, you're just the man for the job. You're gonna help us out, kid. In return, you'll be under my protection. And who knows, maybe you'll even learn a thing or two along the way.
I guess I can't say no to that offer, huh?
I don't remember asking. All right, fellas. Let's get this show on the road.
So how close did you get to Clemente, Vito?
Actually, I never met him. I always dealt with either Henry Tomasino or Luca Garino.
Huh. I can't believe that cocksucker Garino's still breathing.
What was your deal with him?
Well, you know, we did a couple jobs for him, and, Luca said he'd bring us into the family for, $5,000.
What? Typical fucking Alberto. He's always been a crooked bastard.
So what is that, like more than usual?
Yeah, like $5,000 more than usual.
You don't gotta pay to get in, Vito. You're brought into the family once you prove that you're loyal, a good earner. And you can handle, you know, the life. In any case, this is an interesting piece of news. When this gets out, Alberto and Luca are gonna have a lot of explaining to do.
To who?
Jeez.
Don't worry about that. We'll talk about it some other time.
Watch where you walk, Guaylo.
Maybe if your eyes were all the way open, you would have seen me coming, asshole.
Galante. Crooked white devil.
Nice to see you too, Mr. Wu. Crooked? You bet on your own guy and he lost. That's the way it works in this country.
Then Wu offer you a rematch.
I think I can arrange that. You up to it, Vito?
Chinaman, huh? Yeah, get him a stepladder and send him over.
All right, Wu. Looks like you got yourself a rematch. And none of that chop suey crap this time.
Hi, Vito.
Hey, Frankie. How you doing?
I'm doing good. Real good. Thanks.
So, how's things?
Well, I got something to tell you. I'm getting married, Vito.
Oh, Maron, that's great. I mean, it would have been nice if he asked my permission first, but... Hey, I'm happy for you.
Vito, you're in jail. Look at yourself. How'd you let this happen?
Hey, I already got a lecture from the judge, huh? I don't need another one. Just drop it, all right?
Vito, there's something else. It's Mama.
What do you mean? What about her?
She's sick, Vito. She's been like this for weeks, and she's not getting any better.
Look, Frankie. Go to Joe's. He's holding on to my money for me. You get her the best doctor you can find. And, you keep the rest as a wedding gift.
Vito...
No, I mean it. Looks like I'm not gonna need it for a while. All right, looks like I gotta go. Look, you take care of Ma. Tell her I love her.
I will. And thanks, Vito. Bye.
What's the holdup here? Move your asses.
Hey, Frankie. We got a little business to take care of here, huh? Why don't you go have a smoke?
Yeah, sure. Have your fun, you sick bastards.
I like your scars, pretty boy. Where'd you get them?
Sorry, asshole. You picked the wrong ass to drill.
We can do this the easy way, or the hard way. Your choice.
I got a better idea. Why don't you go fuck your buddies instead? Or better yet, go fuck yourself.
Okay. I guess you want it rough.
Come on, boy. You know the drill. Oh, and, this came today. Might want to read it. Looks important.
No! Fuck!
Mama died while Francesca was visiting me. Instead of going toward a good doctor and a wedding gift, every penny I had went to the funeral.
Mr. Galante wants to talk to you. Come with me.
Good to have you back, kid.
What the hell happened?
It looks like the mix weren't up for a fair fight. A couple of them jumped Pepe yesterday.
It was a lot more than a couple.
Yeah, well, we sure as hell ain't gonna let this go.
What do you got in mind?
Pepe's got it all worked out.
Took a little persuading, but O'Neill's all by himself right now in the gym. Guards won't be back for a while. You're just gonna give him a good beating, break a couple of bones, same as they did to me. Got it?
Yeah, I got it.
All right, come with me.
Break a leg, kid.
I'll wait out here. If the guards get back early, I'll warn you.
Okay.
All right, go for it.
Hey, O'Neill. I got a little business to settle with you.
Just the man I wanted to see.
Jesus, what the fuck are you made of?
Oh, you'll have to do better than that, little girl! I'm not gonna be so gentle!
Shut the fuck up. It all worked out just fine. They never found out who did it. Leo arranged for me to relocate to his cell. Well, actually, it was more like a suite. Life was getting better by the minute.
So, Vito, what do you plan on doing when you get out of this shithole?
I don't know. I sure as hell ain't gonna go back to working for Clemente, I can tell you that.
Yeah, you're better off just forgetting about that old bastard. Trust me, Alberto's a real cocksucker. And you can bet that lawyer he's hired was just there to make sure you didn't rat. But don't worry. You'll get his. Letting guys into your family for money like he offered you is against the rules. He's gonna have a lot of explaining to do.
To who? I thought Clemente was the boss.
You obviously don't know how things work around here. You see, there's more than one family in Empire Bay. There's three. Each family controls their own neighborhoods. There's a system of rules. And if there's any disagreements, the bosses of all the families meet to work things out. That's the commission.
Great, so what do I do now? Am I in trouble too?
No. Nothing like that. You're young, you're smart, and you've proven you can keep your mouth shut. You're exactly the type of guy everybody wants working for him.
Yeah, but I don't even know who these other guys are.
There's two other bosses besides Clemente. One is Carlo Falcone. The other is Frank Vinci. Carlo is young and ambitious.
Yeah, the guy's a freaking nut job.
He's new blood. Whereas Don Vinci is a man of honor. He respects the old ways.
You know these guys?
You could say that. And Frank Vinci is consigliere. You think being just a regular old man gets you all this? But listen, Vito. I'm getting out in a few months. When I do, you'll see what we can do about adjusting your sentence. Pepe, come here. Have a taste.
Galante wasn't lying. He called in a few favors and arranged for me to get out early. Knocked almost 4 years off my sentence. Now, Joe used to come visit me and, you know, kind of fill me in on what was happening on the outside. But I tell you, as soon as I walked out of that prison gate, it was like a whole new world.
Vito! Hey, you break out of jail?
Ah, jeez, good to see you in regular clothes and on the right side of the bars again. Welcome home. Come on in.
Man, I tell you, lots changed since I went away.
Yeah, I guess it has. And hey, it ain't much, but I hooked you up with a nice little apartment, just like you
Thanks.
Said. Now I got a surprise for you. We're going out tonight to celebrate, and I'm going to introduce you to somebody.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
You're going to need a little cash so you can get things going again. I got a piece for you, too, if you want it. Ah, here. Always comes in handy.
So, what do you want to do now that you're a free man?
Hey, what do you think? I want to go back to working with you again.
All right. I was worried they might have turned you straight in there.
I actually met a lot of people and learned a lot while I was on the inside. I had a much better idea of how things work now.
Good thing, because I wasn't exactly sitting around on my ass while you was in there. Don't worry, though. I'll show you the ropes, like always.
All right. Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Jesus, I didn't expect you to be raring to go like this, but what the hell? Come on, let's go see your new place. Jeez, I thought you was going to be a no-show. Not bad. Nice material.
Thanks. So, what's the plan for tonight?
You'll find out. A friend of mine's coming to pick us up. I met him when you was on your little vacation. And show him some respect. He's kind of an important guy.
Oh, yeah?
You'll see in a minute. Here he comes.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, Eddie. Here I am. How's it going?
Not too bad. Not too bad. Oh, this your buddy?
Yeah. This is my pal, Vito. Vito, this here is a good friend of mine, Eddie Scop.
Nice to meet you, Eddie.
Same here, Vito. Okay, fellas. I'm dying for a drink. Let's go. So I talked to Leo Galante about you, Vito. He said you were a real stand-up guy, and he told me all about the shit that Clemente tried to pull on you guys. But between you and me, why'd you get into that line of work? I mean, we all got our reasons.
Well,
Yeah.
Because I don't want to end up like my old man. And,
oh, no. Yeah.
Look, I figure nobody's gonna help me, so I gotta help myself.
You do. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Scram, baby. So, Vito, listen. I work for Carlo Falcone, and we're looking to expand our operation. Joe's been working for us for a while now, and since you're a friend of his, we'd like to extend that offer to you as well. What do you say?
Yeah, sure, I'm interested.
All right, let's drink to it. Here's to you guys.
Right.
And to a bright future together.
Touching down.
I can't be drinking too much tonight. I got some business to take care of.
You let other women make a fool of you. Why don't you do right like some other men do?
Really?
Carlo's a real smart guy. He's into, astrology.
You mean astronomy?
Fuck you, you fucking cum dumpster.
Sorry, ladies. Looks like I gotta get going.
Shut your goddamn pie hole. If you wanna use your mouth.
You fellas ready to go?
Vito! Yeah, let's go. Hey, get up, Joe!
If you had prepared 20 years ago, you wouldn't be a woman now.
Hey, I'm going home. Good night, you whores. All right, we're here.
Vito, go pop the trunk.
Is that a joke? That's great. That's just great. Yeah.
God damn it, new shoes. Jesus Christ. Fucking Christ almighty. How long this guy been in here, Eddie?
Just a couple days.
You're gonna have to get him out of there, Vito.
That's just great.
I can't handle the smell.
Some fucking welcome home this is.
Boom! Hey, mother. Hey, here's a hole.
Right here. Dump him in.
Finally, done. Okay. Now who's gonna bury him?
What?
I give me a minute to get a hold of myself. Can you just do it? Every time I get a whiff of the guy, makes me have to puke. And Eddie's not gonna be any help here.
Fine, whatever.
Hey, fellas. How about a little music, eh?
You gotta be kidding me.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go.
This wasn't supposed to be part of your homecoming party, but it's nice out here, ain't it? I ain't been in the woods for a while.
Yeah, you won't be liking it so damn much after I smack you with this shovel.
Sorry, Vito. Not exactly the best way to end the night, huh? But thanks. I owe you one, big time. Leave Eddie's car here so he can get home in the morning.
You're a good man, Vito. I'll settle up with you tomorrow. Hey, you coming in for some drinks?
It's 3 a.m. Shut the hell up!
Hey, shut up, you whore! Come on!
You had enough, Eddie. You're going to bed. Come on. I'll call you tomorrow, Vito. Good night.
Fuck.
Hey, Vito, rise and shine!
Jesus! Marty, stop fucking yelling, will you? My head's killing me.
Oh. Sorry, Joey.
And stop calling me fucking Joey. What the hell's wrong with you?
Vito, come on down!
Jesus Christ.
What you selling, Mac?
You buying or just window shopping?
Maybe.
We're selling smokes. $2 a carton, $100 a crate.
I'll make you a deal. You fuck over 10 cartons and maybe we'll let you and your buddy get out of here in one piece.
Hey, look, pal. How about you get back in your cute little car with your little friends there and I'll pretend I never seen you. Sound good?
You don't get it, do you, you fat motherfucker? This is our turf. And it's gonna cost you to operate here. Now pay up.
You're the one who doesn't get it. You have any idea who you're talking to? One last chance. You walk away now and...
Yeah, I'll tell you who I'm talking to. A fat two-bit fucking Dago door-to-door salesman hocking stolen cigarettes on my turf. And it's time to close up shop, asshole. Okay, boys. I think it's time for a fire sale. Shit. Joe! Oh, fuck. What do you say now, Porky?
What do I gotta say?
That's
what. Come on, hop in that car and let's go.
Hey, Steve.
Hey.
Hey, guys. Marty? What are you doing here?
Hey, Joe. I'm going with you on this one. Steve needed help. He said I could come along.
Steve, isn't this,
Kids gotta learn sometime.
Okay, why are we here, Steve, huh? The guys we're looking for are all headed to the foundry.
This is where they usually meet, so we'll start here. Then head over to the foundry to finish the job.
And, why'd you volunteer to help us?
Those bastards trashed my cousin's car. They robbed him and knocked out 3 of his teeth.
Yeah, those fucking assholes. They make problems all over the city.
Shut up, kid. I'm talking here. So, like the Bible says, an eye for an eye, tooth for a tooth. And, well, we'll just start with this joint.
So what's the plan?
First, we're gonna trash this place.
And how are we gonna do that?
With this. Go ahead, boys.
Hey, come on, guys.
Now you can either help us or stay out of our way.
Let's go teach these fuckers a lesson.
What the fuck was that?
Hey, how'd you get in here?
We followed the fucking yellow brick road. Next.
Nice one.
You fuckers are dead.
Joe, watch out!
Thanks, kid.
Shit, they got guns! Let them have it!
Listen, this got way out of hand. Eddie's not gonna be too happy.
Eddie'll be fine. What are we gonna do? Just let him kill us? These fucking dirtbags won't be bothering nobody no more.
What now, Steve?
Now I'm gonna go home and see if that castor oil's working. I've been blocked up for weeks. I'll see yous later.
Joy, Joe and I still got a lot of work to do. We'll catch you later.
Well, that's a fucking relief. Stupid fucking junkies. Now they know their place. Good work, boys. Here's your cut.
Thanks, Eddie. So, you need anything else from us today, or is that it? I got something I gotta take care of.
No, that's all for today. I'll call you if I need anything.
Morning, Eddie.
Hey, Vito. I'd like to introduce you to somebody. Vito, this is Carlo Falcone.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Falcone.
Vito? So, Vito, how do you feel about Alberto Clemente and Luca Gorino?
Well, honestly, Mr. Falcone, the way I see it, those assholes tried to steal 5,000 bucks from me and then left me to rot in jail.
That's good, because the two of them are planning to make a move on us. So it looks like we're going to have to do something before they do something. Eddie will tell you the rest. I'm sure you won't let me down.
Goodbye, Mr. Falcone.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
So what the hell's going on?
A car with three of our guys in it disappeared last night, and word around town is that Luca might have had something to do with it.
Who's missing?
Harvey Beans and the two guys who were supposed to be protecting him, Tony Balls and Frankie the Mick.
Yeah.
Beans is Carlo's accountant. If he talks, we're all fucked.
What do you need me to do?
I need you to wait for him in front of Freddy's and follow him to find out if he's involved.
And then?
If you find out that he had anything to do with this, you whack the bastard. And if any of our guys is still alive, try and rescue him. Hopefully you can find him before they spill the beans about our operation.
Where do you think he'll go?
I got no idea. So go prepared. Make sure you've got a fast car and some firepower.
All right, no problem.
Okay, stop by here when you're done. And Vito, don't tell nobody about this.
Got it.
Think I don't know about the dope. I know where you got the money. Falcone thinks he's got a good racket going, but he ain't gonna get away with it. Come on, how'd you get it into the States?
I don't know anything. I'm just an accountant.
Don't fuck with me, you egghead bastard. You wanna end up just like your buddy here? Come on. Take a good look. You think you're tougher than him? After we're done with you, we're gonna grind you up in one of these machines here. It's just a question of whether I'm gonna be nice enough to fucking kill you first. Hey, what's that fucking stench? Oh. Hey, somebody's
Drop
over
him.
There. Hey, who the fuck are you supposed to be? Jesus Christ, what is Captain Shitbag here to save the day?
Shut the fuck up, Luca.
Hey, I know you. You're the chump who was hanging around with that moron, Barbaro. I thought you were still rotting in the can. What the fuck you think you're doing here?
Falcone sent me. He isn't too fond of skinny little cocksuckers trying to turn his guys into mincemeat.
So, you joined up with Falcone, huh? Well, I'll tell you what. If you knew what was really going on, you'd realize that you was better off in jail. But that don't matter now anyway. Boys, take care of him. You're so fucking smart, huh? Go ahead, try. Son of a bitch. What's he doing over there?
Hey,
Come here, you fuck.
Leave me alone! Leave me alone,
now
you
I'll
fucking
show you
bastard!
What it feels no, like
wait,
no,
no, no,
God,
wait.
You son of a bitch! I'm gonna have a little fun with Luca before I grind him up. Wanna join me?
Thanks for the invitation, but I think I'll pass.
It's deserved blood, huh?
No. Just hate the sight of Luca.
I hear you, but you're missing out. I think I'm gonna try out that cattle prod he was yapping about.
Yeah. Eddie wanted me to take care of him personally.
Don't worry about that. It'll just take a little longer this way. This fuck don't deserve a quick death.
I can't argue with that. Okay, I'm gonna go. I stink like an outhouse. I gotta get cleaned up.
And tell Eddie he don't gotta worry about Luca. Yo, Beans, open the door. It's all over.
You. You're still alive?
Yeah. What'd you expect? Look, before we go home, you want to give me a hand with Sleeping Beauty here?
You know, that's not such a bad idea.
Oh, shit. This guy, I mean, she's built like a fucking brick shit house, right? She's going down on him, and he's going, oh, God, oh, God, oh, God, oh, Jesus Christ! Was that you? Vito? Oh, Jesus. Why didn't you take a fucking bath before you came back?
You told me to come right back when I was done. You think I'm enjoying this?
Okay, okay, okay. What happened with Luca?
It's done.
All right. How about our guys? You find them?
Yeah. Luca had him in the slaughterhouse. Frankie's dead. But Balls and Beans are fine. Luca was, interrogating him when I got there.
Any witnesses?
Well, except for a dozen or so of Luca's bodyguards who ran
into
nobody.
Back up, okay?
It was rough, Eddie.
Yeah, it sounds like it got pretty hairy. But hey, you pulled it off and you got out of there in one piece, right? So go get cleaned up before you ruin everybody's appetite. And burn those fucking clothes you're wearing. My God. Hey, Vito, you made it.
Hey, Eddie.
Oh, nice threads.
Thanks. So, what's the plan, fellas? What's with the suits?
Vito, Mr. Falcone is gonna bring us into the family tonight. You and me. We're gonna be made.
No, shit. Tonight?
Yeah.
Really? Why didn't you tell me before? What do we gotta do?
You'll find out. But first, there's somebody who'd like to have a little word with you.
Leo, good to see you. What are you doing here?
Hey, kiddo. I want to talk to you about what's going to happen today. Come here, have a seat.
All right, sure. And hey, thanks again for doing whatever you did to get me out of the can early.
Now I made good on my second promise to you.
Second promise?
Yeah. I told you the next time we opened the books, we'd recommend you, didn't I? And now it's done.
You had something to do with this, but you work for Frank Vinci.
Yeah. I would have liked to have had you in our family. But I figure Joe there is your best friend. You guys grew up together, just like me and Frank. And since Joe was working for Carlo the whole time you were inside, I recommended they take you in too when he got made.
Thanks, Leo. I don't know what to say.
You don't gotta say nothing. Not to me or anybody else. That's kind of the way this whole thing works, Vito.
Yeah.
Now, come on. We don't want to keep him waiting. All right. I'll see you fellows upstairs.
What was that all about?
Nah, nothing. Just, you know, talking about old times.
Like that time when old Leo dropped the soap.
Fuck you.
All right, all right, all right. That's enough. Let's go.
Yous are like two school kids, I swear to God.
All right, wait here. Now listen to me, fellas. It's one at a time. Once you're inside, just do as you're told, okay? Joe, come on in.
Hey. Good luck.
All right, your turn, Vito.
Gentlemen, this is Vito Scaletta. Vito. Know that this family of ours is a secret. You are entering the Society of the Chosen, a society which does not exist to the rest of the world. Our family means more to you from now on than your own family, or God, or your country. If I ask you to kill your own brother, you must do it. Show me which finger would pull the trigger. Repeat after me, Vito. If I were to betray the secret of our way of life...
If I were to betray the secret of our way of life...
May my soul burn in hell, just like this saint.
May my soul burn in hell, just like this saint.
Amico nostra. Gentlemen, I give you our new friend, Vito Scaletta. I am very pleased to have these two talented and honest men join us. And I'm happy this has happened in the presence of our esteemed guests, especially Don Frank Vinci.
And his consigliere.
You might wonder why I'd take this risk again after spending almost 7 years in a can. You see, where I grew up, the only guys who mattered were the guys who had the balls to take what they wanted.
You will receive payment for your services from Eddie. Would you like to add anything, Frank?
Whatever you do, gentlemen, stay away from the dope. No dope. That's our policy. You can make plenty of money.
And after years of doing everybody else's dirty work, I was willing to risk anything to finally be somebody.
Everybody, let's have some fun. You only live but once, but when you're dead, you're done. So let the good times roll. Let the good times roll. Don't care whether you're young or old, I'll let the good times roll. Don't sit there mumbling and talking trash. If you want to have a ball, you gotta spend some cash. So let the good times roll. Let the good times roll. Don't care whether you're young or old, I'll let the good times roll.
I went on with a baseball bat, and they looked like they were scared till yesterday.
Fellas.
Oh, hey, good morning, Vito.
Marty, what are you doing here?
Joe said you needed help. And since I did good with the greases, he said he'd take me along again.
Take you along again for what, exactly?
They're waiting for you.
Yeah, well, I'll talk to you later. Yeah, that's my man, Vito.
Morning, Mr. Falcone.
Hiya, Vito. Take a seat.
Hey, guys. So what's happening?
I heard how you got rid of Luca, Vito. Good job. Thanks to you, we now have proof that Clemente was behind the attack on our guys. We couldn't do anything to him openly till now. He just cut his own throat. He kidnapped and tortured our guys, and that means war. Anything we do now, I'm going to be able to justify before the commission. Alberto knows this, so he's going to act quickly and try and come after us first.
So we're going to take out Clemente.
Exactly. Turns out Clemente called a big meeting in the Empire Arms Hotel today. This is our best chance to get rid of him and his top guys.
Oh, sure, yeah. We'll just waltz right in there and kill a few dozen heavily armed men in broad daylight in the nicest hotel in town. Is that about right?
Don't worry. I got a plan.
Shit!
Joe, put that thing away.
Eddie, don't worry. It's safe. I just gotta
For
press
Christ
this.
Sake, put it away now.
Okay.
What's the matter with you?
Okay. You're such a chicken shit.
Okay, so now we're gonna waltz right in and blow up the nicest hotel in town. Isn't that overkill?
Don't worry. This thing ain't that powerful. It won't blow up the whole building, but everybody in a room where it goes off is dead meat.
How are we gonna know when to detonate it?
We'll use a window washing platform. We'll almost be able to watch it explode.
Since when are you the smart one?
Okay, fellas. I'm counting on you. If all goes well... I'll have something nice for you. When it's over, call Eddie at this number. Oh, by the way, I closed the bar today, just in case Alberto tried something.
Hey, good luck, fellas.
Hey, what about that kid in the hallway?
You mean Marty? He ain't part of the organization, so he had to wait outside.
I mean, why is he here at all?
Why do you think? He's going with us because we need a getaway driver and somebody to cover our asses. What do you got against him anyway? I known him since he was a little kid, and he saved my ass with them greases.
Yeah, but we're not fighting a bunch of drunk dirtbags this time. We're about to take out the most powerful family in this city, and you're bringing a kid.
And how old were you when you started doing this shit? You're talking like you're some old fart. Look, Vito, he's gonna wait in the car outside and drive us away. That's it. He ain't even gonna know what we're doing there. He's a great driver, and that's exactly what we need on this one.
Okay, Joe, whatever. But I'm telling you right now, this is a bad idea.
All right, Vito and me, you'll go in and do what needs to be done. You wait for us here. When you hear a big boom, start the car up, because we're going to need to get the hell out of here pronto. And you won't need that gun unless somebody follows us, but that shouldn't happen.
Okay, okay, I got you, Joe.
Clemente rented the entire 18th floor, the third one from the top. There's a couple of suites and conference rooms up there, and guards.
So how are we going to get up there?
Round the back, through the laundry room.
What, you want to wash your shorts before we do this?
Wise ass. The meeting hasn't started yet. We'll grab some hotel worker uniforms, then we'll go do a little cleaning upstairs.
Seriously, when did you become the smart one?
Fuck off. There's supposed to be a guy waiting for us inside with the uniforms. Let's go. And we don't want to make a ruckus before Clemente gets here. So don't go doing nothing stupid.
Shouldn't I be telling you that?
Stay here.
Always a fucking bridesmaid.
Let's go. Move it.
Hey, you two. You got some more work upstairs waiting for you. Get moving.
Hey, Richie, come with us.
That was fucking Henry.
Yeah.
Give me a hand here. Oh, shit. The yellow, the blue, and the plus, and the plus, and the red. And matching negative, blue and cross over here. And perfect.
Okay, the hard part is almost over.
Vito, hold on. I forgot something. Here, this is for you. Just in case something goes wrong.
This is nice.
Some piece of work, eh? 1911 Colt with a modified clip.
What the hell did you,
Holds 23 bullets, so the ammo goes quick. And don't go losing it. These are the only two in the whole world.
Thanks.
Never mind. We gotta go to the window washing platform. Come on.
Come down and give me a fucking
smack! Clemente's guys!
Fuck me. All right, let's get out of here.
Oh, this is like an oyster. Hold on, check it out.
Okay, got it. Take us up a bit.
Payback's a bitch.
Ah, yeah, just like clockwork. Ah, here we go. These assholes ain't...
What the hell was that?
I don't know. Thing just blew.
We'll barely feel it,
right? All right. Let's go take a look.
I don't know why I fucking listen to you. I swear, you're like a half a retard sometimes.
Christ, I almost pissed on my fucking shoes
what
in here!
What a fucking mess.
Felt like a fucking earth, but... what the fuck? Oh, shit!
Lucky bastard.
You assholes! You're gonna die for this!
Get away! Come on, Vito! Marty! No! No! Fuck! They shot him! He's dead, Vito!
Joe, come on. We gotta get out of here. Can't help him now. Clemente's getting away.
Let's go. I'm gonna kill that fucker.
That's the end of him.
Can't be sure unless we check.
Beer.
Give me Eddie's number. I'll call him.
All right.
Hello?
This is Joe. It's done.
Everything went smooth.
No, it didn't.
Why?
Marty's dead.
What?
They got Marty. We left him there.
Okay. What about Clemente?
Done.
All right. Hey. Don't worry about the kid. Small price to pay. The main thing is...
Small price?
Come on now.
That's my fucking friend you're talking about.
Joe, don't go taking it out on me. It was your idea. Nobody forced the kid to go. I'm sorry, but shit happens, right? Come by the Falcon tomorrow to get your money.
Yeah, whatever. The fuck you're sorry?
All right, take it easy now. All right, calm down. I'm sorry, too. More than you think, but you knew the risks.
You too.
Hey, this was a dangerous job. You took him along, he died. What, you think the war was any different? And Eddie didn't even know the kid, so don't blame him.
You should go home.
Okay, well, just give me a minute to get changed.
Huh. I'm sorry, kid. I am so sorry.
Vito, you here?
Right. Where is he?
Over in the corner there. Now look, I tried to cut him off, but the motherfucker was gonna air my ass out if I did.
Okay, lock that door and just give me a minute with him. Had a couple, huh? How you feeling?
Vito, about time you showed up. Everybody went home already.
Gee, Joe, I wonder why.
Oh.
Yeah, right. You drive here?
Nah, I took a cab. I wouldn't park my car in this neighborhood.
All right, finish your drink and let's go.
You fellas about to leave?
Marty,
I'll let you out.
Here's to you, kid. You went out like a man.
Shit, now where'd I put my keys?
I'm so sorry, kid. This never should have happened. Never should have happened.
Oh, Jesus!
Ah, shit.
You gotta be kidding me. What the fuck is wrong with you?
I was just...
You were just what? Shut your fucking mouth and get your drunk ass outside.
All right. I'm gone.
All right, we're here. Try not to shoot anybody on the way to the front door,
huh? Thanks, Vito. And hey, I'm sorry about...
Look, just call me tomorrow, okay? Hey,
Vito.
You got that money for me?
Always keep my word, don't I? Here you go. Don't spend it all in one place.
Thanks. Where's Joe?
He was here before, but then he left. Looked pissed off. Though lately, he always looks pissed off.
Yeah, can you blame him? Listen, I need to talk to you about something.
Well, what, is it important? I'm busy with Vinci right now. He's planning to make a move on us, and we don't know how or why. I gotta sort this shit out.
Yeah, well, I think it's worth hearing me out.
All right, go ahead, but make it quick.
All right. A guy I know who worked for Clemente called me. He's worried. He's not sure if we'll be going after the rest of Clemente's guys or not.
Oh, that's good. As far as I know, the boss ain't planning nothing at this point, unless they try something stupid.
Okay, well, this guy also asked me if he could come work for us.
Yeah? Who is it? What, is he a friend of yours?
I did a few jobs with him for Clemente. Really knows his shit.
Okay, tell him to stop by.
Well, he's here right now.
He is? All right, go get him then.
Eddie, this is Henry Tomasino. Henry, this is Eddie Scarpa.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Scarpa.
Don't call me Mr. Scarpa. My friends call me Eddie. Now take a seat, Henry. So, Vito tells me you want to join up with us.
Yeah, I'm out of work right now. And I don't want to make a big deal out of what happened.
Now that's good thinking. Tell me something first, Henry. Were Clemente and Vinci planning anything against our organization?
Okay. I usually keep my nose out of things like that. But I was with Luca Guarino once at Leo Galante's place, and Luca was going on and on about Falcone being involved in some dirty business and that something should be done about it. I think he was trying to turn Vinci against you.
That bastard. I'll bet he was talking about drugs all the while he's dealing them himself. He knows that Vinci is totally against us. Yeah, probably fooled the old man good. So that's why he's planning to move on us. Now we gotta hit him first.
Again?
Hey, if we don't act, Frank will. First, we gotta get rid of Galante. Without him, Frank's fucked.
Leo?
I wanted to keep you out of it, but I didn't have anybody else who could pull off a job like this. Now I'm thinking this could be the perfect opportunity for Henry here to prove himself. What do you say, Henry? You up for it?
If it means I'm in when the job's done, sure.
Exactly. Take care of Leo. And what about you, Vito? I'd feel a lot better if you went with Henry to make sure everything goes smooth. I don't mean you gotta whack the guy. Just drive there, wait until it's done, and drive back. But if it don't feel right, I can ask somebody else instead. What do you say?
Sorry, Eddie, I can't do this. Leo was like a father to me back in the can.
Yeah, I understand. Well, it looks like you gotta take care of this yourself, Henry. You can hire some help if you want, but you gotta do this so nobody suspects it was us. Leo lives in Highbrook.
Got it, don't worry. It'll be done today.
Okay, you better get going in.
See you later, Eddie.
It's a good thing you brought him here. Even if he screws up, nobody'll know it was us.
I don't think Henry's gonna screw it up.
That's good. Well, Vito, I got nothing else for you today, but drop by tomorrow, okay?
Yeah. I'll see you later, Eddie.
See ya.
Leo! Leo, you here?
How the hell did you get in here? Get out of here! Oh, shove
Leo,
this gun
Leo,
up your
put
ass.
It away! It's me, Vito!
Vito? What the hell are you doing here? You could have called
Leo, there's no time to talk. You gotta get out of here. Quick, they're after you.
What? Come upstairs, Vito. My feet are getting cold. You want a drink?
Ooh, I want a drink. What the fuck is wrong with
okay,
you?
So what's happening?
Look, Falcone wants you dead. The guys are on their way. You gotta get out
what?
Of here.
Why the hell would I do that?
Look, Falcone heard Vinci's planning to make a move on him because Clemente lied and said he was in the dope business.
Lied? Vito, Carlo Falcone is in the dope business. Everybody knows that. Clemente tried to muscle his way into the business, so Falcone got rid of him. Now he wants to get rid of us, too, before we make a move on him.
How do you know all this?
I got my sources. Why did you come here again?
Why? What are you getting senile on me? Because they're gonna kill you! Stop talking, for Christ's sake. Get dressed and let's go.
Why don't we just get rid of whoever Carlos sent to whack me? We got the advantage. They don't know we're expecting them.
I can't do that. I know the guy. I'm actually the one who got him the job.
What? You hired your friend to whack me?
No, not exactly. Look, I don't have time to explain. He's gonna be here any minute.
Okay, wait here. I'll get dressed.
Shit, too late. They're here. Oh, shit. Henry can't see me here. We gotta hide. Quick, before he comes up here. Sheets. All right, here we go. Come on. Tight is tight. All right, go ahead, Leo.
Damn it. Shh, Leo. I'm too old for this shit.
Back down, will you?
If this guy don't kill me, you
come
and
on.
Your crazy
I'm right behind you.
Will.
Let's go.
Right.
So what are you gonna do now?
Well, first, let's get out of here.
No arguments here.
Fucking shit!
Frankie, what are you doing here?
Vito, I don't know what to do. I can't go back home. I don't want to see him ever again.
Whoa, what happened? See who?
Eric!
Your husband, why?
He drinks and he parties all the time.
Does he hit you?
No, but he's seeing somebody. I know he is.
Does he hit you?
Sometimes.
Son of a bitch, I'll kill him.
No, Vito, please don't hurt him. I just thought you could talk to him. He'll listen
Where
to
is
you.
He?
I don't know. He has a friend who lives on River Street. That's usually where he is.
It's gonna be all right. All right, listen. Hey. When you feel better, you go on home. I'll talk to Eric. That bastard doesn't come back today and apologize. You call me, but don't worry. I have a feeling he will.
Okay, Vito. But please don't hurt him. Please.
Don't worry. I'll go talk some sense into him, okay? Consider this a warning. You touch my sister again, I will fucking kill you. Right?
Yeah.
From now on, you're gonna stay home, stay off the dope, stop the drinking, and make sure she's fucking happy. If I ever hear she's not happy, I'll find you and finish the fucking job. You got it?
Yeah.
Okay, everybody, party's over. And there won't be any more partying with this guy again, ever. Unless you want me to come back and do the same to the rest of you. Got it?
Hey, here he comes.
Hey.
What's up?
Hey, Vito. Take a seat.
All right, listen. I've been doing some research into Carlo's business.
So? So, the only reason he had Clemente killed was because he was selling dope, too. And he was stealing his customers. Now he just needs to get rid of one last obstacle. The one guy who could fuck things up and ruin his plan to become the main supplier for the whole city. Frank Vinci.
Where'd you get all this?
I talked to a few people I trust.
Okay. So what does this have to do with us?
Because if he can do it, why can't we? A kilo of heroin costs $2,500 over in France. Then it's another $1,000 to get it here.
And?
And we pick up 11 grand for just driving the stuff to the dealers. That's $7,500 profit a kilo.
Yeah, but what about Falcone?
Carlo won't find out. And even if he does, he'll just threaten us and demand a cut.
All right, but if Carlo's the only big supplier in the city, where are you going to buy the stuff from?
I'm way ahead of you. What do you two know about the Tongs?
The Chinks?
Some kind of organization for Chinese immigrants, right?
That's what I said, the Chinks.
Right, but it's also a front for their other operations. They run the Chinese quarter, and they keep to themselves. But some of them are interested in doing business with outsiders, and they need middlemen since most people are afraid to deal with them.
And we're the middlemen.
Yep. They'll give us 10 kilos to start.
For how much?
35 grand.
And we can sell it for...
110.
Nice.
Okay, well, where the hell are we gonna get our hands on 35 grand?
I know a loan shark. The Yid over on Palisade. I think a loan is 35, we give him 45 back. Now that means our take is over 20 grand a piece. Not bad for just moving the shit from one place to another.
But you know, who's gonna end up using this crap?
What do you care? As long as it isn't in our neighborhood.
Because Vinci was right. Drugs are bad news, they kill people.
Look, only idiots do drugs. Deadbeats and losers. If they want to kill themselves so badly, I'd gladly help them out. Especially for 20 grand. I got buyers in the ghetto. They'll take care of the distribution. So we don't need to worry about that. Are you guys in or not?
I'm in. Come on, don't be stupid, Vito. 20 fucking grand in one afternoon.
When?
Right now. If we don't take the offer, the towns will just find somebody else.
Come on, Vito, it'll be a piece of cake.
Let's go see Bruno, then. Vito, how about you run us all down there? He's on Palisade Street.
Okay, let's go.
Hi, fellas. We're here to see Bruno.
Hiya, Henry. If you got guns on yous, put them down there. I gotta search yous.
Hiya, Bruno.
Hello, Henry. So, to what do I owe the pleasure of your company today?
I need 35 grand in $20 bills.
Oh, that's a lot of money, Henry. A lot of money. Tell me, why should I give that much to a small-time guy like you, huh? Convince me.
I got a sure thing. You'll have 45 by the end of the week.
What kind of sure thing?
Sorry, Bruno. That's a trade secret.
Then 45 is not enough. I'd be more comfortable with 65.
It's a bit steep, even for you. 50's all I can do.
Henry, I have no guarantee I'll get my money back. And you have nowhere else to go. So, how about 60? Don't think of it as interest. It's more like my cut of the profits.
55, final offer. Anything more than that, it's not worth my time.
Deal. I'll give you $35,000 today, and you'll give me $55,000 by Friday. If you don't pay it back by then, the debt goes up by $10,000 every week.
You'll get it by Friday.
Okay. Isaac, prepare $35,000 in $20 bills. Now, you know I trust you, Henry, but if you screw me, remember these wise words from the Bible. And my wrath shall wax hot, and I will kill you with the sword, and your wives shall be widows, and your children fatherless.
Exodus, chapter 22, verse 24.
I'm impressed. You don't seem like the church-going type. But just remember, the money isn't mine. So even if you get rid of me, that doesn't get rid of your debt. So no funny business, okay, boys?
Sure, Bruno.
Thank you, Isaac. You want to count it, Henry?
I'll take your word for it, and I'll bring it back on Friday along with your cut.
I hope so. Good luck, boys.
Welcome, Henry.
Hello, Mr. Wong.
Let us get straight to business. Is your suitcase heavy enough?
See for yourself.
Yo, Da, this is 1磅重的20元美金钞票，一共35,000块.
All right, take it away and bring the goods. You're a good man, Henry. Here is your merchandise. Each bag contains 1 kilo. Each kilo weighs a little more than 2 pounds. Which one do you want to test?
Okay, we're good.
I'm glad. Next time, we can give you twice the amount.
It was a pleasure doing business with you, Mr. Wong.
The pleasure was all mine.
Knock it off. See how easy that was? Let's get back in the car. Hey, guys, how you doing?
Hey, man. Come on in.
Shit! It's smoke! Oh, fuck.
We did it! We hit the jackpot!
Hey, take it easy. We're not done yet.
Lighten up, will you, Henry? What's the matter? All of a sudden, money don't make you happy?
After we pay back Bruno and you get your cut, then you could be happy.
All right.
Hold it inside, baby, diamond ring. If that diamond ring don't shine, he gonna take it to a private eye. If that private eye can't see, he better take the ring from me.
You ain't even gonna give me a tip?
You want a tip? I'll give you a tip. Don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out.
Always the gentleman, huh, Joey?
Just get the fuck out of here already.
Hey, Gina, wanna come join me?
Hey, I hope there's room for three in there. Now we know where to find him.
Let's get in there and take him out before he disappears with the money.
Hold on, I'm gonna need some serious firepower first.
We can either go to Harry's or we can kill these fucks right now. Just say the word.
All gentlemen, this place for member only.
Is your fucking membership.
God damn it, Joe. Can't you listen to me for once?
No, I can't. You seen what they done to Henry. You're dead, you slanty-eyed fuck!
What is it that you want?
What the fuck do you think we want?
We
want
to know why you had our friend killed. We also want the money you took from him.
I had no choice. Your friend was a government informer.
What the fuck are you talking about?
A contact inside the Federal Bureau of Narcotics told me that Henry Tomasino passed them information about our deal.
That's a fucking lie!
Whoa, whoa, whoa. You saying Henry was a rat?
Yes. But not anymore.
That's bullshit. Makes no sense. And I suppose you had nothing to do with the little stick-up after we closed the deal with you either, right?
You think we would take such a stupid risk and destroy our own factory? That was just another reason to get rid of you. We had problems with you from the very beginning.
Yeah? Well, all your problems are just about over, pal. So where's our money?
It's not here anymore.
What?
Where the hell is it then?
I cannot tell you.
If you don't tell us, I'm gonna splatter your yellow brains all over this fucking room.
If I told you, I'd be dead anyway.
Fine, your choice.
Are you crazy?
What you wanna do, let him go or something?
We could've gotten more out of him.
Fuck that, he wouldn't have said nothing. These bastards are tough.
Let's just get the hell out of here before the cops come. This deal was a total fucking disaster.
Tell me about it.
Henry's dead. We don't have Bruno's money. We killed half the Tongs. And if they think Carlo sent us, that'll mean war. We're fucked.
Yeah. And if Carlo finds out we got him into this mess...
What if Henry really was a rat?
No fucking way. Don't even say that. Look, first let's get the money for Bruno. That'll fix at least one problem. But I'm done for today. I need a drink. Call you in the morning. We'll figure this shit out.
All right.
Okay, I'll see you later. And Vito, be careful.
Mr. Angelo?
Yes?
Mr. Salieri sends his regards. Hey.
Vito! Hey, thanks for coming by. I knew I could count on you.
What for?
Frank's organizing a sit-down with the other bosses, and he took almost all my guys as bodyguards. So I don't have nobody around to handle this here job for me.
Derek, these guys still don't want to work.
What? Why?
Because of that deadbeat you fired.
Hey.
Shit. Well, Vito, that other thing will have to wait. Can you help us out here with this first?
What's happening?
Well, this deadbeat didn't come to work for a whole week, pretending he was sick. Total bullshit. So I fired his ass. Anyway, some of his buddies are upset, and they're threatening to strike. All I gotta do is show up with a few guys who look like they mean business. That'll scare them, and they'll forget all about it. I give you $1,000. Are you in?
All right. I ain't gonna say no to that kind of money.
All right. All you need to do is stand behind me and look tough. Right, Steve?
We'll see.
So, what's the problem here, fellas?
We want you to give Big John his job back.
It's me that decides who gets hired and fired around here. And I say he's fired.
All we're asking is for you to hire him back. He's got a family. He needs a job.
I've made my decision.
See, I told ya!
Easy does it, Vinny. We want to do this peacefully.
We bust our asses day in and day out for this fat fuck. And if anything ever happens to us, he'll screw us over just like he did John.
Lower your voice now, young man. I don't want to hear another word about that fucking deadbeat.
Who are you calling a deadbeat? A crate fell on the poor guy while he was working. For you. Broke both his damn hands.
Well, that's his fucking problem, not mine. And I suggest you get back to work before somebody else's hands get broken.
You goddamn bastard!
You fellas are really starting to piss me off.
There's no need for violence. Please, put it down. We don't want no trouble.
It don't look that way to me. Right now, looks like you got big trouble, don't you? Now, if you all don't want to start looking for new jobs, you'll be back to work in the next 10 minutes. You see, Vito, all they do is bitch and moan.
Vito? You're Scaletta's boy, ain't ya? Your dad used to talk about you all the time. You look just like him. But what are you doing working for this bastard? After what he did to your old
man? Shut your fucking mouth right now.
Don't listen to him, Vito. He's full of shit. Come on, let's go.
Full of shit, huh? That bastard killed your father, Vito.
What?
They're just trying to get under your skin.
Derek?
Hey, stop pointing that gun at me.
Why don't you ask him how your dad drowned that night?
We seen him take a walk with Steve. And then Steve come back alone. And all wet.
Stop pointing that thing at me.
What the hell happened with my father, Derek?
Are you nuts or what? Who are you gonna trust, me or these now unemployed losers? We known each other for a long time, Vito. Think of all
Why
the
were
things.
You all wet, Steve? You dive in and try to save him?
Because he wouldn't stay underwater.
Come on, shut! Vito, you swore an oath. I was there. Our loyalty to the family is greater than to our own families.
Tell that to my mother.
Should I kill him?
No, not here. We'll settle things with him later. You disappoint me, Vito. You really do.
I'm gonna do a hell of a lot more than disappoint you, Derek.
Your dad.
Not right now. I gotta get that fuck before he runs away.
Time to teach that fat fuck a lesson.
Vinny, where'd you get that?
Doesn't matter.
Joe wasn't home. At first I thought he was just running a little late, so I went to grab something to eat. Two hours later, Joe still wasn't home. It was getting dark, and I was getting worried. I had to go look for him.
Vito, good, you're here. You hear what happened?
Well, what's going on?
Henry's dead.
What?
The fucking chinks hacked him to death in broad daylight.
Why?
So you don't know anything about it?
Well, Henry wanted to bring me in on some deal, but I passed. What happened?
Yeah, well, Henry is, was stupid. He was dealing dope with the tongs. He knew this was off limits and he got caught. Carlo let him off with a small fine and told him he'd forget about it. But the chinks double-crossed Henry and hacked him to pieces in the middle of the park.
Shit.
Ain't no doing business with the yellow man. But there's worse. Henry wasn't working alone. Yesterday, some guys massacred a shitload of the chinks over in Chinatown. Now they figure it must have either been us or Vinci. They already started threatening Vinci. If this don't get settled fast, we're all in deep shit. You sure you don't know nothing about it?
Not a thing, Eddie, I swear.
Yeah? How about Joe?
Joe? Joe was with me last couple days.
Well, you're lucky then. Carlo's out of town right now, but when he gets back, it ain't gonna be pretty.
No shit.
You better not be shitting me, Vito.
Hey, Giuseppe, I'm looking for Joe Barbaro. Was he here today?
Ah, no, Vito. Yeah, Joe came by today.
Great, I've been looking for him the whole day. Did he say where he was heading?
Well, no, he didn't. I don't think he knew himself.
How come?
Well, he was looking for a job, but before we managed to finish our conversation, a few guys came and took him away.
What? Who?
It was Vinci's people. They said Mr. Vinci wanted a word with him.
You know where they would have went?
No, lo so. Maybe to the bar, the Mona Lisa.
Shit.
Is something wrong?
Not sure. Let's just say we're not on the best of terms with Mr. Vinci these days.
Yeah, Joe didn't look too happy.
I got a bad feeling about this. I better go find out what's going on.
I hope it's nothing serious. Buona fortuna, Vito.
Freeze and maybe I won't kill you.
Hiya, fellas.
Look at the balls on this guy.
Nice to see you too.
Don't move a muscle. Come on, listen to the friendly bartender and stop fucking around, Vito. Now, first of all, I gotta ask you to slowly toss your guns on the floor. No funny business neither. The bartender's got the itchiest trigger finger in town, huh?
I'm not armed.
Okay, so what are you doing here, Vito? We wasn't expecting you.
I'm looking for Joe Barbaro. I heard some of your guys picked him up.
Eh, maybe.
What are you trying to pull? Me and Joe didn't do nothing to you.
Mr. Vinci doesn't seem to think so. He wanted a few things explained to him, so that's what Joe is doing. And since you've stopped by, why don't we go and join them?
And what if I don't want to?
These guns say you do. But don't worry, it's got a hell of a view.
Shit. Ah.
Hey, what's up, Joe?
The assholes went to take a leak.
Great. Well, can you explain to me why the fuck we're here?
That old fuck Vinci can't see what's going on right in front of his face. And he thinks I can explain it to him. Idiot.
Oh, the happy couple is here already. Welcome, Vito.
What's going on? You got no reason to treat us like this.
No reason? No reason? First, the business with Leo. And then all hell breaks out in the city. The chinks, they're going nuts. Everybody's fighting like lunatics. And now, those yellow bastards are threatening to kill me. It's out of fucking control.
Now, I'm too old for this shit, so you're gonna tell me what the hell's going on here. Come on, I'm all ears.
Mr. Vinci, look, I don't know what the hell's going on here. Believe me. Me and Joe ain't got nothing to do with it.
That ain't what I wanna hear.
Yeah, well, that's your problem. Because we don't know shit about any of this.
That's too bad.
Finally. We don't got much time. We gotta do something.
All right. We'll try to break the pipe. Come on, help me out. I can't do it by myself.
Okay.
One, two, three! One, two, three! Again! One, two, three! Need a hand?
I can make it.
What do you want me to do with the money?
Take it to Bruno.
All right. At least that'll be out of the way.
Good evening, gentlemen. Oh, what happened to you?
Hey, Doc. I got my ass kicked and I'm coughing up
what
blood.
What is happening today? One of your guys is already here.
Who?
His name is Antonio Balsamo.
Tony Balls? What happened to him?
Somebody messed him up pretty good. I don't think he's ever going to walk again.
What?
This surprises you? All the blood, all the death. This is the lifestyle you choose. One day your luck is bound to run out. The next time, it could be you.
And off with the sermon, Doc. You have time to treat Joe?
Yes, but you'll have to wait a minute while I fix Antonio up.
That's okay, Doc.
All right, come in.
Make sure you settle things with Bruno, okay? And Vito, thanks.
Sure thing. Feel better.
Good evening. You have the money for me? Or do you wish to extend the deadline?
Here it is.
I have to admit, this is somewhat of a surprise. I heard you boys had some complications.
Yeah, we did.
I heard that Henry is dead. I'm very sorry to hear that. Isaac, count it. So your little business venture was a success?
You got your money, right?
Right, right. It's just that the whole city has been turned upside down. The Chinese think the Italians attack them, so they're going after Vinci. That's not good. Not good. Would that have anything to do with the reason you borrowed this money?
Sorry, Bruno. That's none of your business.
Thank you, Isaac. It looks like the debt is settled. I don't even know your name.
Vito.
Vito who?
Vito Scaletta.
Scaletta. I know a Scaletta once. But I must say, you're much better at paying back your debts than he was. His poor wife had to do it for him.
So it was you who lent my father the money?
Your father. Like father, like son. I see you don't approve. But I didn't make him borrow the money, now did I? Just like I didn't make you. If you ever need a loan, you know where to find me.
Sure. I couldn't sleep. Things were bad, and they were only gonna get worse. The truth was gonna come out sooner or later. And then we were gonna have Falcone after us, along with the Chinese and Vinci. This wasn't how I imagined it when we were starting out. I dreamed of money, cars, women, respect, freedom. I guess I ended up getting all that, more or less. But along with it came prison, living in constant fear, and the blood of my friends. I ducked it as long as I could, but it was finally catching up with me. It was all just a matter of time. Yeah, hello.
Vito. Yeah, it's Eddie. Listen, I need you to...
Let me guess. You need me to come by right away, and I should bring a gun.
For once, I don't. Carlo wants to see you over at the planetarium.
Can you say what it was about?
Nope. Better head over there now, though. Don't want to keep the man waiting. Yeah, see you, Vito.
Mr. Scaletta, can you get in, please?
Hey, old man. What are you doing back?
Just get in the damn car. Now.
And you are?
This is our friend, Mr. Chu.
All right, so what the hell's going on? What is this?
This is about you. You fucked up good, didn't you? Started a fucking war.
Got no idea what you're talking about.
Don't fuck with me, boy. I've probably forgotten more about this business than you'll ever learn. Half our guys are dead. Half of Mr. Chu's guys are dead. And now the feds are breathing down everybody's necks. Because of you.
Leo, listen.
You listen. If it wasn't for me, you would have already been taken care of. So you're gonna listen to what I have to say, and you're gonna listen good. What you did in Chinatown, that was because of that cocksucker Henry, right? You know who he was working for when he died?
You mean when he was butchered?
He was working for the feds. He was a fucking rat. That's why Mr. Chu's people did what they did. And that's why the feds are going after Carlo now. But I don't forget my friends, Vito. You did for me, so I did for you. I called in a few favors. Got you one chance to make this right.
Okay, I'm listening.
You're gonna get rid of Carlo. It was all a favor.
And if I refuse?
You die. Frank and the rest of the commission want you dead. So does Mr. Chu. And to top it all off, you vouched for a rat.
You think Carlo's gonna let that slide? You're a dead man walking.
When?
Now. Every minute we wait is another minute we give to the feds. He's holed up at that observatory of his. You know something's up. Carlo Falcone is a lot of things, but stupid ain't one of them.
All right. Stop the car.
Remember, kid, this is your last chance.
Hey, fellas.
Hey, Vito. The boss wants to see you.
Good. I want to see him, too.
One thing, though, Vito. I gotta take your gun.
Yeah, all right. Here you go.
This is who they send? This is an insult. What'd they tell you, Vito? Take care of me and all's forgiven? You really think they're just gonna let you walk after everything you did? Then again, chumps like you never do think about the big picture. But your buddy Joe understands, don't you, Joe?
What the fuck is this?
I could ask you the same question.
Loyalty's a funny thing, huh, Vito? No such thing as friendship in this business. Didn't your old pal Leo teach you that while you're sucking his cock back in the can? You're just a fucking pawn, Vito. It's all you ever were. When are you gonna realize
Joe,
that?
Joe, you just gotta trust me.
You think I give a shit about the feds? All those tired old fucks on the commission? They're using you, Vito. Just like Clemente used you. Just like I used you. Just like that rat fuck Henry used you. You vouched for that piece of shit. Brought him into my house.
And now, you dumb fuck, you're gonna pay for it. Now, Joe.
Hey, if you're gonna pull that trigger, do it already.
What are you waiting for?
Vito, let's shoot this cocksucker.
Remember what we talked about,
three,
Joe? You're gonna throw all that away? Do it!
Two.
Now!
You know something, Carlo? For the last 10 years, all I'd done was kill. I killed for my country. I killed for my family. I killed anybody that got in my way. But this one... this one's for me.
Fuck you!
Fucking prick.
I sure as hell hope you know what you're doing here.
Don't worry, I took care of it. You'll see. So, what was he talking about back there?
Nothing. He made me an offer, that's all.
Yeah, I figured out that much. What kind of offer?
He wanted me to whack you. Said he'd make me a capo. Give me my own crew. You know, pretty much everything I ever wanted.
Yeah? So why the hell didn't you do it?
Remember that $5 you owe me?
What the hell is this?
It's all right, Joe.
Is it done?
It's done.
All right, then. Looks like a celebration is in order. Come on, let's head to the cat house.
Sounds good to me.
Come with me, Vito. There's more we need to talk about.
All right, we'll see you over there.
All right. So what's the big secret? Hey, what the hell's going on? Where are they taking Joe?
Sorry, kid. Joe wasn't part of our deal.